This video will show you how to use Microsoft Word's citation generator to make an APA reference page. But I want to be upfront with you. I do not recommend using Microsoft Word's citation generator to do an APA citation because it doesn't work very well. So let's take a look at what we can do for that. So go to your References tab and Citations and Bibliography. When you want to add sources, you go to Manage Sources, and I would click New here to add a new source. You don't really want to watch me go through all that trouble of typing that in, but let's look at what we've got here. So we've got the type of source, journal article for a scholarly journal, and you can, you know, do other kinds of sources here. For the authors, when you have multiple authors, you type the last name, comma, first name or first initial, semicolon, and just do that over and over again for each author that you have. If you want, if it's easier for you, if you click Edit here, you can type in their last name and first name here, and it will automatically put them in this format for you. So that sometimes is easier. Corporate author would be if you have an organization as an author instead of, you know, a person. Title of the article goes here, journal name, year, and pages. The page number looks weird because it's an electronic article. So let's take a look at what our citations will look like. So if we go here, go to Bibliography, we'll go References because that's what APA uses. And this is kind of blows my mind that Microsoft Word does this so wrong in the general formatting. So it says References here, which is correct, but it's blue and it's on the left and it's a different font. Like, so it's wrong in three or four different ways. Likewise, you know, you've got the hanging indent for the sources and they're in alphabetical order. It's got most of the correct information, but a lot of small errors. Like, why is it not double spaced? Why is it not in Times New Roman? Why is the capitalization of the title not correct? In APA format, article titles use sentence case. So the first letter of the title, the first letter after a colon, and words that are always capitalized, like proper nouns, or in this case, an acronym, are capitalized. Not like all important words, like they've got here. They could change that for you, but they don't for some reason. I don't know. Okay. What's also annoying is that if you go and change it on this page to change the font and everything, so we can change it like to double spaced. If you do that and then you update the bibliography by going in and editing your sources and doing it again, it undoes it, right? Like, that's not very helpful. I haven't figured out a way to, like, change the template to make it keep it double-spaced and correct font. Maybe there's a way to do that, but it's a lot of trouble, right? Not only that, but this source doesn't even have all the right kind of information, right? So we've got the authors, which is correct, the date, the article title, the journal title, but we don't have the volume and issue number, right? Like this source has. Okay, so if I want to do that, I can go back in and do it. You don't want to just type it in here because, like I said, if you update it again, it'll mess it up. So we will go back in here to the source and edit it. And we can go where it has show all bibliography fields. And we have to know what fields we need to add, right? Because you don't need, you know, the city for a journal article, but you do need the volume and you do need the issue number. You also need the DOI. So in my mind, what is the point of having a citation generator that requires you to know what information goes for each kind of source? Like, that seems to defeat the purpose of having the citation generator, okay? So I do all that. Oh, I forgot to change the capitalization of the title. Let me go back and do that real quick, right? Since it has a colon in the title, the first word after the colon is capitalized. Click OK. We can update both lists. That's fine. And now we can update this again. And so now it has the volume and issue number and DOI. And that looks nice, except for the fact that it's not the right font and it's not double-spaced. You know, but all those hoops that I had to jump through to get it to do the citation correct, and I still have to fix the font and the spacing and the heading. I think that's, you know, completely ridiculous. So I would suggest you know, doing the citations in other ways. So like Night Site citation generator works well. And a lot of websites and databases actually have the option to copy and paste a citation. Here I am on PubMed, and I could have just gone here and highlighted this one. And it does have that one capitalization problem with the title. But, you know, fixing one thing versus fixing like five things, I would fix one thing. Okay, so I hope that helps. Thank you very much.